Hello everyone, welcome to GeeksforGeeks. In this video, we will learn how to count the number of times a given integer occurs in a linked list. So, the problem statement says we have to write a function that counts number of occurrences or frequencies of given key x in a given linked list. Let us see some examples first. In the first example, we have given the linked list 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, and the key value 1. Here output is 4 since 1 is occurring 4 times in the given linked list. In the second example, we have given the linked list 2, 5, 5, 1 and the key value 5. Here output is 2 since 5 is occurring 2 times in the given linked list. Let's see how the algorithm works. Firstly, we initialize the count with 0. Count is the variable in which frequency of the given key will be stored. Loop through each element of linked list. If element data is equal to pass number, then increment the count. Finally, return the count, which is the desired output. Let us now look at the C implementation of the above algorithm. The return type of this function is int, since it will return the number of occurrences of given key in given linked list. This function takes two arguments, the head of the linked list and the key for which the frequency is to be counted. Inside this function, we have initialized a current pointer to point to the head node of the linked list, and we have also initialized a count variable with 0. Then we will check whether this current pointer is null or not. If it is not null, we will check whether the data of this node is equal to the given key or not. If it is equal, then we will increment the count by 1 and then update the pointer to point to the next node. If it is not equal, then we will simply update the pointer to point to the next node. Repeat these steps until the current pointer becomes null. Once we have traversed the whole linked list, means value of current becomes null, the final value of count is returned. The time complexity of this algorithm will be O(n) since we are using linear search for finding the key with the desired value. With this, we end our tutorial. Thank you for watching. Please leave us your likes and comments.